So this is an approach into Tanzanat Airport where a few things almost went wrong, and we'll have a look at what exactly happened. So first, let's have a look at our energy situation. So we are at 20 miles almost, and we are passing 5,500 feet at almost green dot speed. So let's calculate for 20 miles. So 20 times 3 is 6,000 feet, minus 1,000 feet to slow down because we're at green dot, should be 5,000 feet. So at 20 miles, we should be at 5,000 feet. We're not there yet. We're waiting for it. There's the approach phase activated, and there's 20 miles. So we are 500 feet high. Also, the speed is not quite at green dot. There's no wind component here, and the weight is 65.9. So the landing weight on this aircraft is 66. So we are very heavy. Okay, so that's definitely something to watch out for. Anytime you're heavy, you have to be careful not to overspeed the flaps because the distance between, or the margin between VFE next and green dot speed is, or S speed I should say, is quite small. Especially if there's turbulence, this could be an issue. And and you can see on the display here, we are flying through some weather, and there will indeed be some turbulence. Okay, so if we are high on profile like this, especially when you're heavy, you should really fix that right now. But the speed brake is not selected. Okay, so that's not correct. So next profile calculation will be 15 miles. So 15, knowing by heart, this is 4,500 feet. But this is without a speed modification. So we should, with this speed, we should be at 3,500 feet. Now we were already 500 feet high before, and if we don't apply the speed brake, that means that we will also be high on profile at 15 miles. And now at 15 miles, this is also the point where you want to start slowing down to S speed. So select flap 1 and then slow down to S speed. Let me skip ahead a little bit. So the speed is now reduced to green dot, and there's 15 miles, and now flap 1 is selected. So that is correct. Okay, the only thing is speed is not managed. Okay, but so this is also now it managed, but some plans people they don't manage the speed here because they find they are high. But this is not how you solve that problem with a higher speed. What you should do is apply some drag. You only apply more speed when you're close to the approach like this to force the aircraft on the glide slope. But we are already below the glide slope because we're at 15 miles at 4,300 feet, and 4,500 feet is the glide slope, so we can slow down now. That's fine. We need a bit of speed brake though. Okay, so now the speed is managed, and I would now go to vertical speed myself, because you have more control over the descent rate if you are this close to the approach. Okay, indeed, the speed is now changed to vertical speed, although the vertical speed is a bit set a bit on the high side. So in this case, the speed cannot reduce. You will need less than 1,000 feet a minute, about 500 feet a minute, to be able to reduce the speed. But I guess because we are a little bit high on profile, the speed is the vertical speed is increased. But in that case, you need a speed brake. Oh, we have a speed brake selected. Let me see where and when that was selected. About here. Okay, so that's good. A little bit late, but now the speed brake is selected. Okay, good. So in that case, you should reduce the vertical speed a bit more because the speed brake is selected. Anyway, so let's move on. Okay, so now we are getting close to the approach, and you can see already that the distance between VFE next and the S speed is very small because we are so heavy, and especially because we are flying through turbulent weather, this could be an issue with the with a possible flap overspeed. So the way to solve that is you have to fly a little bit below profile, and then fly level at 3,000 feet, and perhaps put the gear down even a bit early to put more pressure on the speed, so to say, so that the speed can reduce quicker if you do select flap 2. But either way, it's better to have a bit of a level segment to make sure that that you don't overspeed the flaps. But this is not the case here because we're exactly on the glide slope here. So here you see it goes into glide slope star, lock star. As we turn the corner, the speed is increasing here, also due to the turbulence. So we cannot select flap 2 now. And okay, now it reduces the vertical speed a bit because we're turning the corner, so it's catching the glide slope. So now the speed is reducing again. So now you could select flap 2 here. So there's GS. But because the margin is so small, you have to be very careful for a flap overspeed. So it looks okay here, but if you actually select flap through right now, you can see right away you are very, very close to VMAX in this case. So let me just repeat that. So there, flap 2 is selected, and you're almost gonna overspeed the flaps. So that was to be expected. You should have seen that problem coming way before, which is why you should fly a level segment and not intercept the glide slope like that if you're heavy. Luckily, we have a lot of headwind here, but on the other side, we're also very heavy. So yeah, the gear down now would be a good idea. You see, it's going very, very close to VMAX. Okay, now the speed brake is selected now, okay. Yeah, personally, I would put the gear down instead. That would be a better idea, and because it's more drag. Okay. So now we need to make sure that we are close to far enough below VFA next for the next flap selection, and you will have to look at the speed here. So if the speed is on the high side, which it is in this case, you should lower the gear 2,500 feet. Otherwise, you might not fly a stable approach. So there you go. Gear down, 2,500 feet. So let me skip ahead a little bit. And not delay selecting the next flaps if you can. Watching, of course, the turbulence. So flap 3 and then flap full. There's flap full. And because of the high, large amount of headwind, the ground speed mean is quite high here. So anyway, we are fully configured. Flap full, gear down at 2,000 feet with the speed on target. That was it. I hope you learned something, and thank you for watching. If you like this video, please consider buying my book, Practical Descent Energy Management. It contains loads of examples of how to manage a descent and approach, and it is the only book available on this subject. There is a paperback and an ebook version available. You can find a link in the description below.